Hello. Oh my goodness. Today was a little tighter than usual. It's good to see you. I'm so happy to be here. I am Stephanie Fine, and today is time for Ounce of Prevention Chat. So what we do is we talk all things weight loss and weight loss maintenance, prevention of weight gain, and all that sort of stuff. I'm Dr. Stephanie Fine. I've been doing this for almost 20 years. I cannot believe I can say that. And today we are continuing our discussion of hunger. So last week we spoke about getting over hungry. And this week, hopefully you got your ounce of prevention in your inbox, we are talking about overeating, which is the flip side of the over hunger. So just to remind you, over hunger is when you let yourself get too hungry, and then you can become a bottomless pit. And so the idea is to never let yourself get over hungry. And one of the ways you can help yourself to do that is by using the handy dandy hunger scale. Let's see, can we see that hunger scale? There it is. There she is. This is the one that you can get free download of, and you just have to go to stephaniefinemd.com/hunger, and it's right there for you. So, I got some feedback from some people. They've been using it. It's been helpful. So, the idea is that it goes from 5, which is completely stuffed, to -5, which is completely empty, and it makes most sense to live is between -2, which is just hungry, and 2, which is satisfied, not full. So that's the key, is the satisfaction. It's satisfied. Now, defining satisfied for you is the trick. And what that will mean is you've had enough food that you will likely be hungry in about 2 to 3 hours, 3-ish hours. And that's right. That's how much food you have in your stomach to process. And then you'll be hungry again. And that's how it works. If you go from let yourself get starving, -5, and then overload yourself at 5, it will last you longer. But it will be so many calories that if you're looking to maintain your weight loss or lose weight, that's not a plan that's going to work. So getting to be satisfied, learning what that is, and eating to that point is the key. Now, I know that sounds like nutso to some people. I remember when it sounded nutso to me because I honestly was used to eating to full. So like uncomfortable, and then sometimes very uncomfortable. But most of the time, that's how I would tell I was done, is when I got uncomfortable. Like, there you are. That's the answer. But it actually isn't. So before you get uncomfortable, and it depends on what you're eating and all the rest of that stuff, there's a time when you're no longer hungry and you're satisfied. That's the place we're looking for. Now, here's the thing I wanted to talk about here. I did not go into this on the blog a little bit, but the hard part about eating to satisfaction is that it's less food than full. I know that sounds basic. I know that sounds like, obviously, eating more food will get you more full. I know. But satisfaction means you might leave some food on the plate. And that is its own set of issues, because leaving food on the plate can bring up all these feelings and thoughts, you know, like the poor children and whatever, you know, insert whatever country you want at that point, you know, clean plate club, like all those sorts of things, all the stuff from when you were little in there. You know, if there was money issues, then that always felt sort of overwhelming. And so it's very difficult. It feels like wasting food. And getting over that is important. It actually is very tricky to get into the mindset of throwing away food. I know. Now, obviously, you don't have to throw away food, right? If you're home, you can pack it up and save it for later. There's, you know, at a restaurant, you can bring it home. What I think I've grown to think about it is, you've already paid for the food. Like, let's say at a restaurant, you've already paid for it, whether you eat a little or a lot. So, just you're not getting more of your money's worth by having it inside your body. So the atmosphere, the people you were with, the look of it, the smell of it, the sound in the restaurant. There's a lot of other things in a restaurant that you can enjoy and have part of your experience without shoving all the portion that the chef decided to put on your plate into your body. That is not a necessity for enjoying your evening out, is having all of it in there. You can enjoy the taste, the intense flavor, the, like I said, the smells, all that in a little amount and still get very much enjoyment out of it. And stopping when you're satisfied means you're not uncomfortable, you're not going to have more calories than your body needs. There's so many benefits, but I know that that way of thinking is not intuitive to everybody. The truth is it probably was, and we got ourselves out of it. You know, I mean, with all the well-meaning people. So, but that's a whole other Oprah. So that idea of eating to satisfaction and dealing with the feelings that come up by having left some food. So, and you know what? The only way to do that is to practice. Practice, practice, practice. One of my favorite, particularly in restaurants, one of my favorite things is to split a meal because you can't eat it. Someone else is eating part of it. So get thinking of that sort of thing and realizing how little food you need. Now, I'm not saying little food, like very little food, but that you don't need, sometimes you don't need the whole sandwich. You know, nowadays sandwiches can be enormous. Even buying bread in the market, those can be enormous pieces. Half a sandwich might do. Now, this is experimental, right? You'll need to figure that out. Like what works for you? But it's a practice worth doing. And this way, this is, you could see how this is the way you get to eat what you want, right? Just not mountains of it. Because you get all the satisfaction and taste you want. So that's one piece of this idea of eating to satisfied. And the other, and let's see. Another thing too, when you are using the hunger scale, remember the hunger scale? This is my pretty version. Is you get the idea that if you're living in the -2 to +2, you are hung. You will get hungrier a little more often, right? Because remember, as I said, you're eating not a ton of food, so your body will use it as it's supposed to, and then you'll need to eat again. And with that idea, as you get to understand the rhythms of your body, you'll need to have food with you. So if you know you're gonna need a snack around 3, but you're out running errands, then you're gonna need to have something with you, just so you can satisfy that hunger. Because remember, if we let it go, it just gets bigger, and then we overeat calories at the next meal. So that's what we're trying to avoid. Overhunger leads to overeating. We can prevent overeating by not getting over hungry. That's really the big takeaway from this piece, the eating to satisfaction and the not, last week was not getting over hungry, and this time it's not overeating to full and to stuff to over full. I call it very, very full. That's what it is. It's full, satisfied, full, very full, stuffed. So 5 is stuffed, and hopefully there's never a reason to go to stuffed anymore. It's literally physically uncomfortable. And we don't need to be physically uncomfortable. There's plenty of things that happen without us trying. So that's that one. And I talked about in order to get to feel what satisfied feels like, remember, you're going to have to experiment a little on that. The way that you can really get connected with how you're feeling physically is if you eat when you're not distracted, which is another one of those things that sounds nutty too. Because most of us, or a lot of us, eat in front of the TV, we eat with the podcast, we eat with reading, there's lots of different ways that we do that. That's all distracted and taking us away from the connection between what's in our mouth and how full we're feeling. So when you're learning to do this, whichever meal you can, try this, not distracted. Oh, scrolling through your phone. Oh, that's a major one. If you can sit and eat It is absolutely incredible what you taste and sense. And that gets you satisfied really quick. It's remarkable. I can't tell you how much of a difference it means until you try it, because I've tried this experiment and it's amazing. Eating without being distracted will allow you to feel satisfied. You can then identify that feeling and you can eat to that, and then you won't be overeating and have extra calories. So the distraction piece was one of them. And then the other piece about eating to satisfaction is filling foods. So if you're eating proteins and fiber, that's going to fill you up, and you'll register that a lot faster than the calorie-dense foods. And I talked about that in the blog. A calorie-dense food means 50 calories of it is a small amount. And an example is like a cake or a cookie. You know, a small amount will get you a lot of calories. But you can eat tons of broccoli for 50 calories, and you could be, you know, full. So choosing wisely will also be the way that you can watch the number of calories that you're eating. It's very easy to eat cookie after cookie after cookie after cookie. Some of the processing is already done for you in that cookie so that your body isn't having to, and you just can sit there and you don't register it as quickly. So looking for the best filling foods, protein and fiber and water, are going to be the lowest calorie for the most bulk. And so that's good connect. So you have that and you have non-distracted eating. So that is what I have for you this week. And next week we're doing part three of hunger. It's a three-part series. And we're going to talk about emotional eating, because that's the big piece, right? If it was only fuel, it would be one thing. But for a lot of us, that's not the case. There are some people on the planet who do just eat for fuel. I'm always amazed. I'm always amazed by that. But anyway, that's not me, and that's not the people who I work with and know. So we will go on. But if you want to print out a hunger scale, it's right here. You can stick it on your fridge. Just go to StephanieFineMD.com/hunger. And you can get it right there. It's great to see you this week. I will see you next week. Same time, same place. Bye.